Now the question arises, what happened in the Free State? I explained to you that because of the extermination wars, where black people were at war with one another, the big tribes almost exterminated the smaller tribes. The big tribes like the Zulus under King Shaka went into war with the smaller tribes and drove them away from big areas of South Africa. They left the area. They were killed. And as I explained before, they even turned to cannibalism because there was nothing to eat. When Andries Hendrik Potgieter came into the Free State area, that whole area was virtually empty. Andries Hendrik Potgieter came into contact with the Baralong in that area, and later on with the Bataung under the leadership of Makwana. As I said, that area was completely empty, and Makwana was completely traumatized by the extermination wars where the leader of the Ndebele under the leadership of Mzigazi Silkats had completely cleared the area. He virtually exterminated that area, and that's the reason why Makwana was completely traumatized and asked the support of Andries Hendrik Potgieter against Mzilikazi and his Ndebeles. They agreed that the area between the Vet and the Vaal River would be given to the Voortrekkers to settle on in exchange for 29 cattle. Once again, it sounds ridiculous that such a big area could be given to the Voortrekkers in exchange for 29 cattle. But cattle were very valuable at that time. And over and above that, that area was empty. Nobody lived there. And the Makwana and the Bataung and the Makwana welcomed Hendrik Potgieter to live there so that he could protect them against Mzilikazi Silkats of the Ndebele. That's why the Voortrekkers in increasing numbers settled in that area, because everybody agreed that that area was empty. And in 1836, in battle with the forces of Mzilikazi, Mzilikazi was defeated and fled across the Limpopo River into the present-day Zimbabwe. That area was empty, not only the Free State, but most of the areas north of the present-day Pretoria and Johannesburg, the Limpopo province, was completely empty because of the actions of Mzilikazi. And because the Voortrekkers under the leadership of Hendrik Potgieter had beaten Mzilikazi and his forces, they claimed that area as their own, because as a result of a war that they had won, they had acquired that area as an area on which the Voortrekkers could settle. If you want to order a copy of this booklet, the booklet can be obtained at a very reasonable price at the address that is being shown on the screen.